this isn't something you see every day on Max machines. This is a Cold War Delta Wing fighter. It's actually a Gloster Javelin. And these came around in the early 50s and were in service till the early 60s. And they were made in Gloucester's Morton Valance factory, which is not very far away from where I live. And there was an aircraft runway there. Sadly, it's now mainly sort of fields, I think. Most of it's been sort of returned back to Earth. But it played a very important part in the early days of the jet age. And I'm here at the Jet Age Museum, admiring their fantastic display of Gloucester-related aircraft and engineering. But this Delta aircraft, I've got my camera on a pole because it's really quite big. You know, this is a twin-engine plane with some really big old engines in there. They're actually Armstrong Siddeley engines. Those SA-7R engines with reheat released something like 12,000 pounds of thrust at 20,000 feet, so more than enough power in this aircraft. And although it was considered to be subsonic, a great anecdote at the museum is a test pilot didn't like these reports of it being subsonic, so flew it above Fleet Street and broke the sound barrier in it just to sort of prove a point. You just can't imagine something like that in the modern age, can you? The trouble you'd be in. But hats off to, I think it was Chief Test Pilot Dickie Martin that did that to show the British engineering was more than up for the job for supersonic speeds. Although I think a thinner winged variety variant even was produced later on that didn't go really into production that would have been for higher speeds. The aircraft reportedly was really, had good flight characteristics. One instance where, you know, if the engine, an engine was lost, it would easily fly on one engine. One terrifying incident, both elevators were lost on one of the aircraft, and the test pilot managed to bring it in using the trimming capability, the large tailplane, and thrust changes to control pitch. Now, that is absolutely incredible, isn't it? I certainly wouldn't want to have been that pilot. But again, an incredible story that the plane, the skill of that pilot, and the plane's overall inherent characteristics got them home. This aircraft, of course, was replaced by the English Electric Lightning, which is an aircraft I can't wait to see in film. I've heard so much about the Lightning, was so excited by it when I was growing up. But I didn't know much about this aircraft, so I'm delighted to see the one that went before it. The Lightning, of course, being nearly twice as fast, and there's some legendary stories about Lightnings. But today we're here to look at this magnificent beast, the Javelin. Another really interesting feature of this aircraft can be seen as we walk around the back, and that's the pen nib feature, which was a sort of extended fairing around the jet nozzles, and it reduced the buffeting on the tailplane effectively. But look at that, you can see it, can't you? They were set back and then, you know, nozzled out. Very, very interesting plane, and, you know, enormous wing. It really is something to behold. So get down to the Jet Age Museum in Gloucester and have a look at it. Fantastic. You enjoyed that video. I certainly did enjoy seeing that fantastic museum. If you do like to continue watching these videos, please feel free to subscribe and like the video if you wish to. But appreciate you made it to this point, so thanks very much. Cheers for now.